comrades and friends, warmest greetings of solidarity in the anti-imperialist and democratic struggle of the people. As chairperson of the International Coordinating Committee of the International League of People's Struggle, I would like to give you basic information about our league. We wish the broad masses of the people and their mass organizations to participate, support, or cooperate in the work and struggle of the ILPS. We invite all anti-imperialist and democratic organizations to apply for membership in the ILPS. The League promotes, supports, and develops the anti-imperialist and democratic struggles of the peoples of the world, including the workers, peasants, women, youth, professionals, and other sectors of society, against the ideological, political, military, economic, social, and cultural domination and attacks of imperialism and reaction. The League has a broad mass character, is not subordinate to any political party, government, or religious authority, and affords equality to all member organizations. It strives to realize the unity, cooperation, and coordination of anti-imperialist and democratic struggles throughout the world. The ILPS engages in various forms of educational work to shed light on the nature of imperialism, to show the direction of the struggle, and to rouse the people to action, seeks to expand and consolidate its organizational strength by engaging in campaigns and activities to mobilize the people in cooperation with other forces.
So if you ask me how is imperialism impacting us? Oh, in many, many, many different ways. I cannot even tell you all. Pakistan was formed in 1947, and imperialism was immediately at play, especially the United States has had a huge hand in how the country has adopted privatization as its core foundations, as its principles, and how it has developed. To this day, we are totally unable to produce the most basic of products for the country, especially medicines. We cannot produce any medicines. The Americans have had a huge role in how they have defined our military, and for nearly 60 years of this nation, we've had more than 30 years of military control. And every time there has been a martial law and a general has come into place, he has been a pawn of the Americans.
We have natural gases, and nowadays the imperialist oil and gas company, they are plundering our natural gas. The ruling class of Bangladesh, they are the allies of the imperialist, especially US-led imperialist, and they supported their foreign policy, like, you know, their occupation in Iraq and Afghanistan.
The US imperialist troops are present in our country, especially in our region. They did these military exercises together with the Philippine government to control us and to take advantage of our natural resources.
Within the United States, the Mexican community is being persecuted and criminalized, because a lot of Mexican immigrants are undocumented. So what we face in our everyday life is raids all over the place. We have deportations, we have killings, there is a lot of unemployed people, there is a lot of poverty.
The power of capitalism is intense, but not unsurmountable, not unbeatable. Till there are peoples who are resisting, till there are nations who are resisting, can, of course, push back these forces. But there have to be broad alliances. Because once we have an organized sector of the broad masses, whether it be women, whether it be workers, whether it be farmers, or it be migrant workers, it doesn't matter. Every sector of the economy has to be reached out. Every sector of the social sector has to be reached out. Because people are suffering. And it is much easier to organize now. It's not only just much easier to organize now, but it is a need of the time. Without a strong wall, a chain of people, we cannot push back the atrocities of capitalism. And we have to, we not only have to push back, we have to make them surrender to the people's voice, to the people's democracy.
The crisis of global capitalism has become worse from decade to decade and from year to year under the neoliberal policy of imperialist globalization. It is comparable to the Great Depression in severity and destructiveness. It has resulted in widespread unemployment, low incomes, soaring prices of basic commodities, and deteriorated and yet more expensive social services. It has led to austerity measures and the exacerbation of exploitation and oppression. It is whipping up fascism and more wars of aggression. In both the imperialist countries and dominated countries, the broad masses of the people are undergoing terrible suffering. They are driven to fight for their democratic rights and for their national and social liberation. There is urgent need to build and strengthen the people's organizations and to wage resolute and militant struggles. The International League of People's Struggle stands as a rallying point of the exploited and oppressed peoples.
I declare open the first International Assembly of the International League of People's Struggle. We welcome all of you in the spirit of anti-imperialist solidarity. We thank you for responding to our call to come to this assembly to establish the International League of People's Struggle as a broad anti-imperialist and democratic mass formation. We are thus gathered in an occasion of great historic importance. The League answers the urgent need of the broad masses of the people for the creation of an international solidarity, of a rallying force in the struggle for national independence, democracy, and socialism. It is their weapon against the intensifying exploitation and oppression unleashed by free market globalization and the new world disorder under the hegemony of U.S. imperialism.
There is a rise, there is state fascism hiding behind the cloak of the so-called war on terror. Repressive laws in the fashion of the United States Patriot Act are being passed. Right-wing partners and neo-fascist groups have become emboldened to instigate national chauvinism, racism, and religious bigotry among the people. We are still in an era in which imperialism is dominant. But there is a countervailing trend. Countries want independence. Nations want liberation. And people want revolution.
if correctly applied, the policy and tactics of the United Front at the national and international levels do not constitute opportunism. They are necessary for the revolutionary forces to grow from weak to strong, to expand their mass following and influence at any stage, split the counter-revolutionary forces and defeat them one after the other. A genuine revolutionary force can apply the United Front policy and tactics only if in the first place it has its revolutionary integrity, develops its own strength, and exercises its own initiative and independence in order to isolate and destroy the enemy.
We believe that the ILPS is the biggest mass people's organisation in the world, and obviously our objective is to radically reshape the world so that the benefits of the wealth produced by the people goes to the people.
And how do we do that? By mobilising the people to resist exploitation and oppression amidst the protracted global depression, state terrorism and wars of oppression.
The International Assembly is the highest decision-making organ of the League. It meets once every 3 years, but the International Assembly's the highest leading organ is the International Coordinating Committee, whose members are elected by the International Assembly. The officers of the International Coordinating Committee constitute the International Coordinating Group. There are functional organs called the commissions under the International Coordinating Committee. There are also territorial organs under this committee. These are the national chapters and global region committees. Any organization or formation of a mass character that agrees with the charter of the League may apply or may be invited to become a member organization of the League. The application is evaluated and acted upon by the national chapter as soon as possible after such application is submitted. In cases where the national chapter does not exist, the International Coordinating Group receives and acts on the application for membership, subject to approval of the International Coordinating Committee. All member organizations maintain their independence and initiative, and accordingly have equal basic rights and duties. The International Coordinating Committee is assisted by 17 commissions. They are responsible for the research and study of 17 concerns of significance on the scale of the world, global regions, or particular countries. They issue position papers and timely statements on current events and issues. They work to raise the political consciousness of the member organizations of the ILPS and strive to attract organizations to join the ILPS or cooperate with the ILPS on major issues and initiatives. They propose initiatives to be undertaken like campaigns, conferences, forums, seminars, and protest mass actions. They can go as far as to initiate or assist the formation of new international organizations on the basis of definite interests, concerns, and issues. The ILPS makes a stand and wages struggles on 17 concerns. The ILPS is guided by the International United Front policy. It initiates or joins mass campaigns or occasional activities of mass mobilization and broad international conferences along the anti-imperialist and democratic line of struggle. The League brings together and coordinates people's organizations according to common multi-sectoral and sectoral interests and purposes. It initiates and launches mass campaigns and various types of activities and seeks the cooperation of other anti-imperialist and democratic forces. At the same time, it joins and supports their initiatives. The League has initiated and led activities such as protest actions against the oppressive and exploitative policies and acts of the imperialist and puppet states, like the wars of aggression and plunder against the multinational companies and imperialist-dominated international agencies such as the IMF, World Bank, and WTO, whose policies further impoverish the world's people.
In the spirit of international solidarity and in accordance with the United Front policy, the ILPS maintains and develops fraternal relations with other international anti-imperialist and democratic formations, such as the International Action Center, the Beirut International Forum, the International Anti-Imperialist Coordinating Committee, the International Coordination of Revolutionary Parties and Organizations, the United National Anti-War Coalition, the Bolivarian Movement in Latin America, and various people's associations for solidarity with Asia, Africa, and Latin America.
The broad masses of the people are waging struggles against imperialism and all kinds of reactionary forces. They constantly raise the level of the revolutionary consciousness, organization, and mobilization. We are confident that the people's resistance along the anti-imperialist and democratic line will lead to a fundamentally new and better world of greater freedom, democracy, social justice, all-round development, international solidarity, and peace. All these are attainable in a socialist future.
Let us break the chain of oppression, defeat the wars of aggression, with every strike, with every fight.